Let's talk about the Colonial Pipeline cyber attack in the United States. This was supposedly a ransomware hack. It shut down this gasoline pipeline that goes from Texas all the way up to the US East Coast. And there were supposedly all these cars queuing up, fuel prices skyrocketing, all of this chaos created by this ransomware attack. And basically what it is a cyber attack that freezes up physical infrastructure and won't unfreeze it unless a ransom is paid. They're accusing this group, DarkSide, of being behind this, and they keep claiming that it is a Russian-based or rooted group. If we look at this Reuters article, Russia denies involvement in Colonial Pipeline cyber attack, and Russia's denying it because they're being accused of it by the Western media, of course. Now, the U.S. government isn't directly accusing Russia, but we have to remember there's been years and years of both U.S. government and Western media accusations leveled against the Russian government. So here, President Joe Biden said there was no evidence thus far that Russia's government was involved, but said there was evidence that the culprit's ransomware was in Russia. And then down here, the FBI attributed the cyber attack to DarkSide, a group believed to be based in Russia or Eastern Europe. So they don't even know whether it's Russia or Eastern Europe and believed to be. So this is what you say when you have no evidence and you can't prove anything. You say believed to be. And they're saying it's ransomware targets computers that do not use keyboards in the languages of former Soviet republics, cyber experts said. But then again, cyber experts should be aware of WikiLeaks Vault 7. Vault 7, CIA hacking tools revealed, and this marble framework. And what this was all about was obfuscating the source of a cyber attack. So basically setting up your code so that it resembled the algorithms and even the written language of one of your adversaries, so that when you carried out this cyber attack, it would be falsely blamed on your adversary, not you who actually carried it out. So this was the CIA creating a whole suite of tools to do this, to include algorithms known to be used by groups operating, say, out of Eastern Europe or out of Russia, to use languages from other regions of the world. So if you come down here, you actually see that. You see Arabic, Chinese, this is Russian, Cyrillic, Korean, and Farsi. So they would include that. They would include different algorithms. And then when these experts looked at it, they would think, oh, well, that looks like it's from Russia, when in fact it was from the CIA. And if the CIA was doing this, this means pretty much anyone probably could be doing this, especially after WikiLeaks revealed this in its Vault 7 disclosure. So when you see Reuters or here's the New York Times, they have a very similar article, FBI identifies group behind pipeline hack, and they say almost the exact same thing, believed to have roots in Eastern Europe. And what they're doing is this very vague type of accusation. This is what the Bush administration did in the lead up to the 2003 invasion of Iraq. They never directly accused the Iraqi government of being involved in the September 11th, 2001 attacks on New York and Washington, but they did a lot of this very vague roundabout accusations, trying to link Saddam Hussein with Al-Qaeda and these terrorists that attacked the US. So even though they never accused Iraq directly, they made enough vague accusations that the American public leaped to that conclusion themselves. And if you were to ask the Bush administration, and I believe people actually did, they would say very straightforward, we never accused the Iraqi government of that. But you'd be surprised how many Americans still in their mind think that that was a fact, that the Iraqi government somehow was behind 9/11. It's the exact same thing Reuters, the New York Times, and many others are doing right now. They've just spent years accusing Russia of everything from meddling in elections to threatening U.S. infrastructure. And now they're making these very vague accusations. They know their readership is going to leap to that conclusion themselves and spare them the embarrassment of accusing Russia directly and then having evidence pop up saying that it's not true. Then they will be able to say, well, we never directly accused Russia, did we? And of course, they didn't. But they're being dishonest because they're leaving out Vault 7 and those CIA hacking tools that allow the CIA and anyone else, for that matter, to falsify attribution for any given attack. So we don't know who carried out the Colonial Pipeline attack. The prices are rising. Oil companies are benefiting from it. So in any crime, ask yourself, who's benefiting from it? Is Russia benefiting from it? Whoever did the ransomware attack, if the ransom was paid, they definitely benefited from it. But do we know that that was a Russian cyber gang and not the CIA or one of the CIA's partners carrying this out, or someone who's trying to provoke conflict between the US and Russia, some third party? They say it's from Eastern Europe. Maybe it's someone connected to the US-backed regime in Ukraine. So I just thought I would point this out. Reuters and the New York Times isn't gonna remind you about WikiLeaks, Vault 7, and these CIA hacking tools. I will remind you because I want you to realize how hard it is to figure out who did this by just looking at the code. The code can be falsified. If you thought this video was useful, please like and share it. Think about subscribing to the channel. It's free to do and it helps the channel grow. Check the video description for the link to this Reuters article as well as to the WikiLeaks Vault 7 disclosure. And there's also ways you can help support my work so that I can continue making videos like this. And as always, thank you for watching.